Hey, it's Allison from computers.mom, and today's video is all about the password manager built into Google Chrome. I find that a lot of people don't know their way around it, which is a shame because it's incredibly helpful and easy to use once you know how. Before we dive in, should you use a password manager? Security experts recommend using one because it will help you keep track of your passwords safely and accurately, saves time and frustration, makes it easier to use good, strong passwords, and even helps you avoid some scam websites. There are a lot of password managers available, but if you use Chrome, the web browser from Google, you already have one. Chrome includes a free and powerful password manager that is turned on by default, meaning that it automatically saves and autofills passwords for you unless you turn it off. So Chrome users often have a bunch of passwords saved already, whether they knew it or not. Well, there's no such thing as perfect security. Our passwords in Chrome are protected by the security settings of your computer and your Gmail account, so they're pretty safe. You can see, search, edit, or delete those passwords whenever you want, and Google can even check your passwords for security issues. However, no password manager is perfect, so we'll take a look at some of the quirks you may encounter too. So let's take a look at how to use it. We'll cover getting started with the password manager, saving passwords, using saved passwords, seeing and editing passwords, and cleaning up your passwords list. Don't worry about taking notes, you'll find a recap of the key steps at the end of the video. The first step is to open Chrome. Find the familiar colorful circle icon and click on it. Now locate the profile icon, that's the little circle in the upper right-hand corner. If you're on a Google web page, you may see two of them. The one you want is the top one up here that is directly to the right of the address bar, not the lower one. When you click on it, if you are already signed into Chrome, you will see your name and email address like this. But if you see a little head like this instead, then you're not signed in. In that case, go ahead and log into your Gmail or Google account using whatever method you have set up. In this case, a passkey on my phone. In your case, it might be a password, a fingerprint, or face recognition. You also want to be sure to turn on sync, because that keeps a copy of your information securely stored in the cloud in case the computer dies or gets lost or stolen. Once you are signed in, the password manager begins working automatically. Anytime you go to a website, like Etsy, for example, and register for an account, a window pops up asking you if you want to save this login. You can check the details for accuracy if you like. To make the password visible, just click on the little eyeball symbol right here. When you're ready, click Save to add this login to the password manager. Easy peasy. What if you change your password? Let's change the one we just created. This website requires that we enter the current password in order to create a new one. When you click in the field for the current password, your saved login pops up. Just click on it and Chrome will automatically fill in the password for you. Now we enter a new password twice, and Chrome is smart enough to notice and this time asks if we want to update the saved password like this. Let's click Update Password to keep our password list correct and current. Let's close Chrome and start fresh. Now anytime we return to a site that we've saved in the password manager and we want to log in, the username and password are automatically filled in for us, no typing required. Normally, it's just that easy. Of course, this is only true if you are using Chrome. Passwords you save here will not show up if you're using a different browser, like Microsoft Edge or Safari. Notice that when you click in one of the login fields, you have the option of opening the password manager here if needed, but there are other ways to get there. Option one, click on the profile icon again, select Passwords and Autofill. That opens the Chrome Autofill and Password Settings page in a new tab. Notice that you also have access here to payment methods and addresses. Very helpful to have those automatically fill in on websites, but we're not going to cover that today. Click on Google Password Manager, and here we are at the main Password Manager page in a third tab. So that was easy. Alternatively, click the three dots menu right next to the profile icon. Then in the menu that appears, point to Passwords and Autofill and select Google Password Manager. Both options take you to exactly the same place, but option two is a bit quicker and more direct and only opens one new tab. Now we're looking at the list of all of our saved passwords, organized alphabetically by the name of the site. We can scroll through it, but there are a lot of them, so it's usually faster to use the search box at the top here. Just start typing the name of the site, and in most cases, you'll find it very quickly. Suppose you want to see the password for Pinterest. Type the first three letters in the search box, and the list is automatically filtered down to only sites that contain those three letters. Advantage Shopping, which has PIN in it, and here's Pinterest. You don't need to type the whole name. If you click on Pinterest in the list, you don't immediately see the details. First, you have to verify your identity. That's crucial because we don't want just anyone who has access to the computer to be able to get to all of our passwords. Whatever method you normally use to unlock your computer is also used to unlock your password list. In this case, it's my fingerprint. On your computer, it might be your login passcode or Face ID or whatever, but it will be something familiar. Once we get past the security, we can see the login details for this account. I've been using the term password for convenience, but it would be more accurate to call this a login because it's not just a password that gets saved. Each login consists of three things: the address of the site you are logging into, your username, which is often but not always your email address, and a password. The combination of those three items makes up one unique login. The username and password fields both have buttons that let you copy them if needed, and the password also has an eyeball button that makes the password visible or hidden. You can also edit your passwords if needed and add any notes you might want right here. Let's click the back arrow to return to the main password list. We're not seeing all of them because we still have PIN in the search box. To see the whole list again, just click the X to clear that last search. I mentioned earlier that the password manager is not perfect. It is often full of outdated, duplicate, or just plain wrong information. For example, notice that many of these sites have multiple logins saved. Citi.com, which is Citibank, has 5 accounts. If we open it, notice that we don't have to do the security verification this time because we already did it and we haven't left the password manager. It remembers that we are already verified. You can see that these logins have different usernames. The first one doesn't have a username. That's not going to work. This one has the username in all caps. This is my husband's username. And this one is the result of the Citibank website hiding the username by substituting stars for part of it. You've probably seen that. The actual username does not have stars in it, but it got saved as a separate login anyway. In reality, we probably only have 2 separate logins, mine and my husband's, and you might be tempted to delete the extra logins from the list, but we haven't even looked at the passwords here. They might all be different too. So we don't know yet which logins on this list will work. Oh, except the one with no username, that definitely won't work. If you have multiple logins saved like this and you don't know which one is correct, the only way to know for sure is to test them on the site in question. Let's try that on the Staples website. You can see that there are multiple usernames saved for Staples. If we click here on the site name, it takes us directly to the site in a new tab. When our cursor is in the login field, the various options that were on my password list are all listed, so we can test them one at a time. Once you've identified the correct login, you can easily go back to the password manager and delete the bad ones if you want to. Back to our list. The second issue you might run into is that some sites don't allow the login to save automatically. For example, you won't find your Google or Gmail password saved here unless you add it yourself. If you have a login for a site that isn't automatically saved, you can add it manually if you want to. Just click Add up here at the top, fill in the 3 parts of the login, and save it. That way, you have a record of the information if you need it. Also, be aware that some sites are saved with unexpected names. The most common example of this is Microsoft. If I search for Microsoft, I won't find it. You just have to know that for whatever reason, Microsoft logins appear in password lists under live.com. Notice that it does have the Microsoft icon, though. This raises a point I want to make very clear. Just because a login is saved in the password manager doesn't mean it is correct. You may have changed it somewhere else, like in an app on your phone, so it didn't get updated here in Chrome. The password manager is very helpful, but it is not perfect. For all of these reasons, your password list can get pretty messy. Often, clients will look at their password list and say to me, "Oh, I don't even use half of these anymore. I'm going to delete them." I usually advise them not to for 2 reasons. One, this is your history. You never know when you might need this information again, and it's not hurting anything by sitting there. Two, life is too short to waste your time trying to keep this list perfect. Don't worry about clearing out the stuff you don't need. Just be sure that the passwords you do need are saved. Before we stop, I just want to point out the very useful checkup option on the left here. That checks for passwords that have issues. I'll cover that in another video because this one is long enough already. Oh, and one final point. You now know that all these passwords are being synced to your Google account in the cloud. So if you have the Chrome app on your smartphone and you are signed in and the password manager is on, you can find all those saved passwords available on your phone as well. Just tap the three dots menu at the bottom right corner, scroll across and tap Password Manager, unlock, and here we are. This should look familiar. So when you're away from your computer, you can still access all those saved passwords if need be. Here's a quick recap of the essential steps on one page for convenience. To use the Google Password Manager on any device, open Chrome and make sure you are signed in and have sync turned on. Passwords will be saved and filled and updated automatically if you are using Chrome. To access saved passwords on your computer, click the three dots menu on the upper right, point to Passwords and Autofill, and select Google Password Manager. On your phone, click the three dots menu on the lower right, scroll right in the icons, and select Google Password Manager. Unlock using your normal authentication method for that device. And tap on the dots to see the password. Thanks for watching. Please click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.